So this is a great topic. Are those cheap photographers really hurting your photography business? Welcome to White House Studios. My name is Arash. I'm a longtime photographer. And one of the areas that I specialize in when it comes to sharing information with photographers is pricing. And Annabelle, I was gonna say Defoe, but it's actually D-F-L-U-X. And I'm not quite sure how to pronounce that, but I wanna give her full credit. She has a post over at Digital Photography School, and it's about photographers taking work from other photographers due to cheap prices. And she asked the question, do cheap photographers take work away from the rest of us? And that's a good topic to address. And so what I'm gonna do is go through the list of headlines. If you wanna read the entire article, head on over to Digital Photography School and dig in and get her angle. But I wanna address the headlines, and then I'll talk about her conclusion a little bit too. And the rest of it is up to you. I wanna hear from you in the comments. What do you think? Do photographers really take business away from you just because they're a lower price? Annabelle starts off with the idea that there is a client for everyone. And I have to agree with that for the most part. However, I think sometimes we forget, especially when we've established ourselves as a professional, how hard it is to get where we want to go, how hard it is to find the client we're looking for. And that's why it's really important for you to define the client that would appreciate your work. Who is that person? Are they looking for high volume photography? Are they looking for the best value for the price? Or are they looking for the very best and high production photography available to them? There are many different types of clients in both the retail space as well as the commercial space. But you have to understand who your client is and what their expectations are. When you understand what their expectations are, price is not as big of a deal because you are providing them exactly what they're looking for and they value what you are offering them. And that's the biggest thing, is understanding who values what you're providing. When you are working at the, you know, the commodity level of photography pricing in the photography world, which is quite often the entry-level world, people are all about price because they don't have a track record to work off of. And if you are trying to build your business, you're just trying to get experience, and it's a tough place to be. And honestly, there are people who are just looking for the cheapest photographers, and it doesn't matter how good you are, how much value you bring to the table. The fact is, they can't afford you, nor do they want what you're offering. They need somebody just to do the job. As I often refer to it, as people looking for a photographer. Ultimately, you don't want to be a photographer. A photographer is somebody who can just do whatever needs to be done at whatever price is offered or is available, whatever it may be. It's usually the lowest price. You want a photographer. You want to be a photographer that people are searching for. You want a client that wants you. You want a client that is looking for your portfolio. And once you understand who that client is and how to find them, it makes it a lot easier to develop your photography business. Next, she brings a little reality into the conversation in number two. Client priorities are not always the same as yours, and that is the truth. Again, you may have a high value service, but not everybody wants to pay for a high value service, just like we were talking about. The fact is, some people really want cheap, and you can't get them no matter what you do as a client. It doesn't matter unless you come down to the price level that they are willing to offer, you're not gonna get them as a client. So the thing is, when somebody wants a cheap photographer, they're going to hire a cheap photographer. That is their priority. And you have to remember, we have another element in all this, free photography. Free photography comes in the form of a smartphone. Somebody just saying, hey, I'll just do it myself with my smartphone. And quite honestly, there are many situations where the smartphone truly gives the client or the prospect everything they could possibly need for that situation. These smartphones are really getting good, and the software that's coming with them is replacing the need for photographers as a whole. So sometimes when they decide, hey, you know what? I don't really want to do it myself. They're looking for the convenience factor of not doing it themselves. And they figure a professional photographer will be a lot more convenient than doing it themselves. That's the priority, the convenience, not the fact that this is a professional photographer. So you have to remember, you need to think about what are those priorities? What are the priorities of your prospects? What are the priorities of the people that you're not winning the bids for? And then think about what are those characteristics? Because after a while, you'll start to realize, you'll see the commonalities in those prospects that really are not right for you. A big part of understanding where you need to go to find your best client is to understand who is not your best client. Number three, some clients will eventually understand the price versus value point. Well, maybe, but I wouldn't count on that. I wouldn't wait for that one to happen. Some people may change their mind as their needs come into play. The thing is, a lot of times people pay for higher value photographers because they have more on the line. For example, somebody whose job depends on hiring the best photographer to make sure everything goes right. Maybe they're in charge of hiring the wedding photographer. Maybe they're in charge of hiring a photographer for a big production as it relates to a commercial photography shoot. It has to go right. They have more on the line. So they understand the value of a good portfolio and a reputation of a photographer who's going to produce exactly what they need. They know it's going to work. The risk is very low by hiring that photographer. The risk is often much higher to hire somebody who is inexperienced, and they may be very good, but they don't have all the experience. If something goes wrong, they very well may not know what to do. I'm not saying everybody. Everybody comes in at a different level. Everybody has a different style to react to situations. There are veteran photographers who quite honestly don't respond very well to bad situations, and there are newcomers who do a great job. So, again, it's about their reputation and brand that they bring to the table. And quite often, when you develop that reputation over time, you will start to find people who are willing to pay a little bit more for the security that you offer. But that doesn't happen very often. It's not one of those situations where this company one day is going to realize they need a high-value photographer. And that this mother-to-be will need a specific style of baby photography. Now, if you can show that you are offering something that she really appreciates, maybe you need to step it up. It's not them finding or understanding the value. It's about you bringing the value to the level or in a way in which it strikes something. Quite often, it's emotion. You bring something to the table and it hits them just right with emotion. And that emotion will kind of trigger something in them that'll say, hey, you know what? I'm willing to pay a little bit more for this photographer. Number four, express your value and stand by your worth. And this is excellent advice. I've said it many times before. If you go after the crowd that's looking for a commodity photographer, for a photographer, chances are those people very well may refer you to other people who are looking for a cheap photographer. Remember, people who want a cheap photographer want a cheap photographer. They are not taking business away from the more expensive photographers. We just wish that there were more people that are willing to pay more for photographers. The fact is, there's more need for photography than ever before. But there are also more photographers than ever before. So it's important to stand your ground and develop who you are. Don't worry about the competition. If you are focused on the competition, you're looking the wrong direction. Stand tall with who you are and look for the clients that are willing to refer you to other people who see your value based on your reputation, your brand, and the work that you create. Number five, find your demographic and market to them. And it's a basic fact. You can know who you want your client to be, but if they don't know who you are, then it's not going to do you any good. You need to get in front of the right people. And it's important to develop a plan around four areas of marketing: awareness, traffic, conversions, and retention. Develop awareness of who you are. That's branding. Drive traffic to your website or to your studio door. It's up to you, but I would say your website is a good starting point. Then conversions. What is the best call to action that you have? How can you get people to say yes to you? That's improving conversions, and that's including in your elevator speech or your calls to action on your website, your forms. There are many ways in which we get people to act. Continuously testing and trying to improve the conversion rates of what we're doing is always probably the best thing we can do. Once we understand how to get the traffic, we need to learn how to convert it better, and that's a never-ending process. Number four is probably one of the areas that most people kind of forget about, and that's retention. Retaining the people that already know you, like you. These are people who have used you before. Well, these are people who could refer you and give testimonials. Keep in touch. Communication, email, social media. They all support retention. Retention is about communication. And speaking of social media applies to all four of those areas. That's why it's so good for photographers, especially photographers who are trying to get their imagery out there. The nice thing about social media is that we can show our work to people who are very interested in photography and what we have to offer, and we can keep in touch with them over time and also introduce our work to new people. And if they like our work, it's going to catch their eye and opportunities will develop over time. So awareness, traffic, conversions, and retention. You have to market to the people that you want as new clients. Number six is what we talk about all the time on this channel, and that's stop worrying about what others are doing and charging. If you're worrying about that, as I mentioned before, you're headed in the wrong direction. You can only focus on developing your brand and finding the right people for your work. Because there are a lot of people that want nothing to do with your style of work. There are people who don't need food photography or senior photography. There are people that want to spend very little. Some people, as I mentioned before, are just looking at their cell phone and thinking, you know, I can do it. Why would I hire somebody? But again, we have to present why. And that why, quite often, especially if you are a beginning photographer, is the convenience of hiring you. If you're a more established photographer, it's to lower the risk and to provide the type of work that they're looking for that may be a little bit beyond or a lot beyond their capabilities, especially with a smartphone. There are a lot of different ways to approach photography. And you can't just be a point and shoot kind of photographer these days and expect to have a solid career. You have to have more than that. You need to bring something new to the table that is yours. And when you can do that and understand the business side and the marketing side, you're going to have a much better chance of providing a quality career to you and your family because you have done the work that it takes. Photography, the photography business, is not just taking pictures and going home and delivering images later. It really is a business. 10-20% of our time is actually photographing. If you want to be a successful photographer, yes, you need to photograph every day, and quite often that has to do with personal projects, which also help develop your brand and reputation, who you are as a photographer. But for the most part, you need to understand how to find new clients and keep your clients. When you can do that, that's going to be very beneficial, and you'll understand the basic fact that you don't need to worry about those other photographers who are less money, because you have a community of people who appreciate the work that you're doing and they're willing to pay your price. Annabelle wraps up her post with a conclusion that I think is fair, but you have to be realistic too about the photography business. She says that you have to not worry about the cheap photographers. You need to focus on bringing your value to the table. And look, it can be frustrating. You're going to find a lot of people who don't see the value in a photographer today or only want to pay for cheap photographers. There are many of them. And at times it may seem like there are more of them than there are people who understand your value. But it really is important for you to develop your value of why you. Quite often, it's about relationships. Quite often, it's selling you more than your photography. You have to bring different elements to the table that other people are not. And the fact is, nobody has your eye. Nobody has your brand, your reputation. When you get the right combination together, you can go out there and find your community and have an exciting, rewarding photography career. Hey, Annabelle, thanks for writing the article, and I'll see you in the next video.